Good afternoon, students. Last week we discussed the properties, border properties. We discussed there in case you want to control the border. Border can be attached on any paragraph or heading tag or in the case page, case of your image or table. We can control it with the help of one property. There is a border properties are there. So in the case of your border, there is border width, border color, border type. But when we implemented these properties in CSS, the appropriate result was not there. The correct result was not there. Here is another property of border is simple border. Okay, so it is working. So we are going to discuss this one. So you will take here border, then column, then it is a combination, it is a combination of all these three properties: border width, border color, border style. So first we will take border width. It will be in pixels. Okay, so for example 2 pixels, so you can take pixels, 2 pixel, 4 pixels. Okay, so you can also take like a thin, medium, and a thick. So you can also take these values here. So these are values of a border width. Okay, you can take in pixels like 2 pixel, so 2px, 4px, 7px, 9px. There is no any you can say limit is here. So you can take width, and after that you will have to give here space. Here you will take the border style. Okay, so border style, here we can take it as a solid. Okay, so border color you can take, different styles are there. Solid is there, then dotted, then dash, double, groove, ridge, inset, outset. So these are the different border styles. Okay, so according to your choice you can take anyone. And last one is border color. Suppose you want to take border color green. Okay, so these are your border properties. In this, border width, border color, and border styles creating problem whenever we are using them. But border properties work, it is properly working in all the browsers. Clear? So I am now giving one example. I have created one external CSS. Clear? In this, I am taking property border 6 pixels, border style groove, and border color is green. Okay, and same CSS I am importing in one file, that is one.html, and here I declare one id. So us id ko main paragraph mein import kar raha hu, और साथ में मैं एक इमेज में भी इंपोर्ट कर रहा हूं, ठीक है, आईडी इज इक्वल टू ओके, आईडी इज इक्वल टू ओके, सो टू प्लेसेस आई एम इंपोर्टिंग दैट आईडी, सो आई एम सेविंग दिस एंड going to open that file in browser. So in Google Chrome. So here is border. Board, same border is in image as well as in paragraph. Border is of green color. Second is it is solid, clear. And next one is in place of group. In place of group, I am taking here solid. Feel the difference. Observe the difference with here. So this is solid. Clear. And in place of solid, I am taking here dashed. So I am taking here dashed and refreshing the page. So this is your dashed style. Then in the place of dashed, I am taking double. I am saving this. This is double. Then which with the two combination will be there, one is black and another is green. Next is inset. So in inset, upper portion will be dark and lower portion will be light. Then outset. So it will be reverse. Upper portion will be dark and then lower portion will be dark. Upper portion will be light and lower portion will be dark. So this is all about border property. If you have any doubt, raise your hands, beta. Akhilesh, it is clear? Beta, quickly unmute yourself. Madhav, clear? Raghav?
Yes.
It's clear, beta? Okay. Now, after that, there is another property that is called float. Okay? Now, in case of your content, here is a one paragraph is here. After that paragraph, there are some text contents are there. And then there is a one image. Okay. And by default here, image is in the separate line. There is no any wrapping of text. So float property provide us wrapping of text with the image. So here in my CSS, I am creating one more one feature here, float, right? So your contents will be along with object. I applied this on paragraph and image. So here your contents are with your contents. Okay. So this is called a float property. So if you have any doubt, raise your hands with us. Jayaditya, concept clear? Now, next is in the last lecture, we started the next topic of HTML. So, CSS is complete here. We started a new topic. One minute. Bhumika, unmute yourself. Okay, students, in HTML, which are included in the second term, tables, then your hyperlinks. So these are the part of your term two, and how to insert audio and video in the case of your in HTML document. These are the part of term two. Bhumika, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
But last week we started which topic? Table or image? Table or hyperlinks?
Sir, table.
Okay. Okay. So in tables, we discussed table is a presenting your data in the shape of rows and columns. This is an organized way of presenting the data. The horizontal arrangement is called rows and vertical arrangement is called columns. For this, you will have to use one tag that is called table tag. It has starting and closing. Okay, so today I'm going to create one table, and I'm creating this table in first MS Word, and after that I will create the same table in HTML. So I am going to insert one table. In this table, I will take here roll number, then name of the student, then marks. Then I am taking here roll number 1, roll number 2, roll number 3. Name. Marks. Now, so contents are here. Now, my first row is bold and center aligned. Okay. So, how to create the same table in HTML? Clear? So, in HTML, I am typing only the table coding. In HTML, first you will start with one tag that is called TR. TR stands for table row. So in case of HTML, we can insert the data row wise, not column wise. So in first, we are using TR. TR stands for table row. And in this table row, in first cell, there is a row number. So I am taking here TD, then row number, then TD close. But there is one problem. In TD, the contents will be normal. It means left aligned and simple content. In case you want to make your content bold and center aligned, you will take it as TH. TH stand for table head. So here, first row, all the cells in first row are bold and center aligned. So that's why we are using here TH in place of TD. So second cell, here is a name. And close TH. Third one again, TH, marks, and TH, close. Next is close TR. The first row is complete here. Now we are going to create second row. For this, use TR again, and then in place of TH, use TD, because text is normal, not center aligned and bold. So I am taking here TD, that is row number is 1, then again TD. So name is Amrit. TD closed. These are container tag. Next is TD. Marks is 78. Then TD closed. Then you will close TR. So my second row is complete. Start third row. Remember one thing, number of cells in first row must be equal to number of rows in second cell. It means all the rows must contain same number of cells. Start again TR, TD, row number is 2, then Manav, then marks, that is 81, then close tr, then again start tr, td, and then marks, and then close tr, then close table tag. So now I am including the basic tags of HTML, HTML, then head tag is here, then title tag, tables, title tag closed, head tag closed, then start body tag, because HTML has two sections, body and tables, and last you will close body tag and then HTML tag. I'm going to save it. Save as, type all files, and name of the file is table.html. So my web page is here, table.html. So my contents are here, but outline is missing. For providing the outline border, there is a one property of body tag is, table tag is border. So border is equal to, here you will give the size of your table, border size. So here border size, border outline is here. And you can also change the border color. So for this, there is a one attribute, border color equal to green. If you want to change the background color of your table, give it beachy color. So BG color property, the BG color attribute we can use in table tag. So it is applicable on complete table. We can use in TR, then it is applicable on the cells in the same row. It is also applicable on any TD or TH. In that case, it will be applicable only on single cell. Clear? Now, next is, we can also align the table in the center, right or left of your web page by using align attribute. Align equal to center or right or left. By default, it is left. So this is your left alignment. Okay. And in case, in any row, you can also use align. Okay, whenever we use align attribute in TR or TD or TH, it will align the content. Okay, it will not align the table in reference to the web browser. Suppose here in rule number 2, I am using here align equal to right. So cells are complete row. It is right aligned. Even we can also change the VG color here. So I am saving it. VG color equal to. Okay, we can also use the VG color. We can set the VG color of any cell. For example, in rule number 3, if you want to change the alignment or color, you will do like this. In the TD, align equal to center and VG color equal to pink. So this is your table. Raghav, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Now next is, in a table, there is very less space between the cells. Okay. If I want to increase the space between cells, there is one attribute of table tag, that is cell spacing without any space between cell and spacing equal to give here any number. So I am taking here 5 pixels. Okay, here is the gap between different cells. This is called cell spacing. Suppose I am taking here 10. So this is a extra space between the cells is called cell spacing. And if I want to give extra space between the content and cell border, it is with the help of cell padding. So I am taking here cell padding, no space between cell and padding equal to 10. So it is space within the cell. This is space around your content. Now, who will tell the by default cell padding is by default? If I am not giving cell padding, what will be the amount of cell padding? Yes, Baljinder. Very quickly unmute yourself and give the answer.
Cell padding.
Yes, cell padding by default amount, by default value. It is 2, beta. By default, it is 2. Agar aap value nahi dete, to ye 2 hoti, beta. Always remember, cell padding mein amount by default 2 hoti, agar aap nahi dete. Now, next is, in case you want to set any image as a background of your table, then there is background attribute. So I am taking here one image as a background of your table. So I am removing VG color attribute and taking background. Background equal to now name of the image. So here is one image, saved in my computer. So I am giving that name and then saving my picture file and refreshing my web page. So here is an image as a background of your table. The image is not properly displayed here due to its size, very large size. So that's why. Okay, students, any doubt in this? So we discussed here different properties, different attributes, border, border color, VG color, background, align, cell spacing, cell padding. And we have also discussed, we can use the align attribute in TR and TD and VG color property, the attribute in TR and TD. Here, in the case of TD, we can also use not in table, here in TD or TH, we can also use V align. V align attribute. This is called vertical alignment. So it will be by default, cells are, if your site, there are two more properties. First of all, I am going to discuss that height and width. Height and width of your table. So I am here taking height is equal to 50%. You can take in percentage or in pixels. Width equal to 30% of your web browser window. Okay. So this is height and width. Suppose I am increasing the height. It is 70%. Or you can also give the in the shape of pixels. So I am taking 400 pixels. So your contents are sent, V align is always middle. So you can take V align, suppose in the case of rule number one, I am taking V align equal to top. So by default it is center, align is always left and V align is always center, middle. So you can change it. So here roll number is at the top. Okay. So now time is over. Now I am going to close the meeting. Thanks for attending the meeting.